So hello everyone and welcome back once again to the session of government schemes. In this session guys, we are going to discuss about a very important scheme of the Ministry of Rural Development which was launched in the year 2016, and the name of the scheme is what? Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Rurban Mission. Okay, it's not urban, it's Rurban Mission. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes, और इसमें बहुत अच्छे अच्छे questions आते हैं in the form of quiz, and you can also receive all the notification of the latest videos on this Telegram group, alright? And this is the scheme that we are going to discuss. It's Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Rurban Mission, or you can say National Rurban Mission. Okay, it can also be called as National Rurban Mission. Okay, so now let us first try to simplify the objective of the scheme. Let us first try to determine the objective of the scheme. Now, what is the name of the scheme? Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Rurban Mission. So there is only one word jiska matlab hume pata hona chahiye, and if we know the meaning of that word, we can easily determine the objective, and that word is what? Rurban. Alright, so what is the meaning of Rurban guys? Rurban means developed cluster of rural settlements. Developed cluster of rural settlements, which means Rurban cluster means a group of adjacent villages. A group of adjacent villages which are developed. A group of adjacent villages which have sole of the rural areas, but they have developed facilities like the urban areas, which brings me to the motto of the scheme, which is Atma Gaon Ki, Atma Gaon Ki and Suvidhaen Shahar Ki, Atma Gaon Ki, Suvidhaen Shahar Ki. This is the motto of this scheme, Atma Gaon Ki, Suvidhaen Shahar Ki, which means soul of rural areas and the facilities of urban areas. So I hope the meaning of Rurban is clear now. What is the meaning of Rurban? Basically, Rurban cluster is a group of adjacent villages which are developed and which have facilities like the urban areas. So through this scheme, government wants to promote development in the urban clusters. Government wants to make more and more urban clusters. And how many urban clusters are being targeted to be developed? So these are 300. 300 urban clusters are targeted to be developed as the urban clusters. Okay. So I hope guys the objective is clear. Let me repeat the object. So to identify the urban clusters and develop them. This is the basic objective, and how, which kind of development? All types of development like economic development, sanitation development, education development, health development. Har tarike ka development will be provided in these rural adjacent villages to make them as the urban clusters. Okay, and how many urban clusters will be developed? 300 in the 5 years. In the total span of 5 years, 300 urban clusters will be developed under this scheme. Okay, so I hope guys the objective is clear, and of course the ministry is rural development. Since we are talking about the rural villages, a group of rural villages we are talking about, so therefore the implementing ministry should be the Ministry of Rural Development. Okay. And guys, these are the components of the scheme. Which types of development will be done in these urban clusters? Kis kis tarike ki development ki jayegi? Kaun kaun si facilities provide karai jayegi? So these are the various components, and of course these components aapko yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai. These you should not remember. Skill development training linked to economic activities, agro processing, agri services, storage and warehousing, fully equipped mobile health unit, upgrading school or higher education facilities, sanitation, provision of piped water supply, solid and liquid waste management, village streets and drains. Then we have street light, inter-village road connectivity, public transport, LPG gas connections, digital literacy and citizen service centers. So basically developing the village in all its sphere. Har sphere mein jo village hai ya jo urban cluster hai uska development karna hai. Koi bhi life ka sphere yahan pe nahi choda jayega. And this development guys will be provided through the convergence of various centrally sponsored schemes, various central sector schemes and various state government schemes. All right, basically isme kya hai ki isme alag se koi provisions nahi laye jayenge. Jo existing centrally sponsored schemes hai, existing central sector schemes hai ya state government schemes hai, unko converge karke these developments will be done in these urban clusters. Okay, and just for example, skill development ke liye there are various initiatives of the government of India, like we have National Skill Development Mission and National Apprenticeship Promotion Scheme. For example, for sanitation, of course, we have Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen. For example, for solid and liquid waste management, again, it's Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen. For street light, we have SLNP project, we have Ujala project. For LPG gas connection, we have Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana. For digital literacy, there are various number of schemes from the central government. So through the convergence of these schemes, these development will be done in the urban clusters. So remember, there is no separate provisions for any kind of development that will be done in these clusters, right? And now there will be an integrated cluster action plans that will be prepared by the state government, and they will also be presented to the Ministry of Rural Development. So the state governments prepare a detailed integrated cluster action plans, and is plan mein kya hoga? So it will contain all the details, and which kind of details of the scheme being converged, implementation framework and the mission outcomes. Kaun kaun si schemes ko converge kiya ja raha hai for the development of a particular cluster, kaun se implementation framework honge and mission ka kya outcome hoga. Okay, so this action plan will contain all the details. Okay, and it also provides the tentative cost. What will be the tentative cost to develop that cluster? Okay, so this integrated cluster action plan is developed by the state governments, and these are presented to the Ministry of Development for the Ministry of Rural Development for the approval. Okay, and moving ahead to the institutional framework. Now, institutional framework mein, and guys, this also integrated cluster action plan, here just remember one thing. What is the name of this plan? Integrated cluster action plans are being produced under this scheme, Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Urban, and these are prepared by the state governments. That's it. Isse zyada kuch bhi isme yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai. And moving ahead to the institutional framework. So yes, institutional framework mein aapko ye pata hona chahiye ki national level, state level, district level aur cluster level pe kaun kaun apni responsibilities ko pura kar raha hai. Who are responsible at the national level, at the state level, at the district level, at the cluster level, you should remember. So at the national level, there is a national mission directorate which is headed by joint secretary in the Ministry of Rural Development. At the state level, any department or any agency that is being nominated by that particular state government. At district level, we have district project management unit, and also at the cluster level, we have cluster development and management unit. Okay, so ye aapko yaad rakhne ki zarurat hai. These are the things to remember. Okay, you should remember this ki national level pe kaun kaam kar raha hai, state level pe kaun kaam kar raha hai. Okay. And moving ahead to the empowered committee. So this is also, guys, are important. Empowered committee mein, at the national level, we have an empowered committee which is headed by the secretary under the Ministry of Rural Development. And don't confuse between the National Mission Directorate. Which was headed by joint secretary. Here it is the empowered committee which is headed by the secretary. Okay, don't confuse. And it has the responsibility to approve the ICAPs, integrated cluster action plans, and critical gap funding that jo ki submit ki gayi hai states dwara. Now what is this critical gap funding, we will discuss later, don't worry. And at the state level, there is a state level empowered committee which is headed by the chief secretary of that state. Okay, us state ka jo chief secretary hoga, he or she will head this empowered committee. And what is the role of this state level empowered committee? So it recommends or approve the ICAPs before submitting to the mission directorate and empowered committee at the national level. Jo national level pe yahan pe empowered committees ka approval karti hai, wahan tak jaane se pehle this will be presented to the state level empowered committee, and they will have the responsibility to approve that. Okay, and now let's talk about the very important part of the scheme, that is the project funding. So as I told you, there is no separate provisions. The development under this scheme is done with the convergence of various government schemes. Okay, so the project is being funded through the convergence of various central government schemes, central sector schemes, or the state government scheme. But there is very important thing that you have to remember here, that if there is any gap between the availability of funds from the converged scheme, jo converged scheme se funds aaya hai, if there is any gap between the availability of funds from the converged scheme and the funds that is required for the development, then that gap will be filled by the critical gap funding. Okay, so I hope critical gap funding is clear. Critical gap funding basically kya hai? Ki jo gap hai between the availability of funds and between the required funds, usko fill karne ke liye jo funding hogi, that is known as critical gap funding. And this critical gap funding, guys, will be provided by the central government. Remember this, central government degi ye critical gap funding. So एंड देर इज अ कंडीशन ऑल्सो, ऑफकोर्स सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट कैन नॉट प्रोवाइड अ लॉट ऑफ मनी बिकॉज उनके पास भी ऑफकोर्स लिमिटेड रिसोर्सेज हैं. सो द सीजीएफ इज कैप्ड एट 30% ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट और ₹30 करोड़ विच एवर इज लेस. या तो प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट का 30% या फिर 30 करोड़, जो भी कम होगा इन द प्लेन एरियाज एंड कोस्टल एरियाज. प्लेन एरियाज और कोस्टल एरियाज के लिए कंडीशन है. वाइल इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द डेजर्ट हिली और ट्राइबल एरियाज, द सीजीएफ इज कैप्ड एट 30% ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट कॉस्ट और ₹15 करोड़ विच एवर इज लेस. ओके, 30% का कंडीशन सेम है, लेकिन वहां पे कितना है 30 करोड़ और यहाँ पे कितना है 15 करोड़, और दोनों में से जो कम होगा. ओके, एंड देन वी हैव वन मोर टाइप ऑफ फंडिंग इन दिस स्कीम गाइस, विच इज नोन एज इनोवेशन बजट. नाउ व्हाट इज दिस? इट इज एन एडिशनल अमाउंट ऑफ 5% ऑफ क्रिटिकल गैप फंडिंग दैट हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड एज द इनोवेशन बजट फॉर रिसर्च एंड डेवलपमेंट इन द श्यामा प्रसाद मुखर्जी रर्बन मिशन. ओके, सो दिस इज अबाउट द फंडिंग एंड गाइस दिस प्रोजेक्ट फंडिंग पार्ट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, स्पेशली दिस क्रिटिकल गैप फंडिंग. इसमें से क्वेश्चन कई बार पूछा जा चुका है एंड इन फ्यूचर वी कैन ऑल्सो एक्सपेक्ट सम मोर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दिस पार्ट. ऑलराइट, एंड मूविंग अहेड टू द स्टेप्स दैट आर बीइंग फॉलोड इन द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द स्कीम. कैसे कौन कौन से स्टेप्स इसमें फॉलो किए जा रहे हैं, व्हाट इज द प्रॉपर स्टेप्स दैट आर बीइंग फॉलोड व्हाइल इम्प्लीमेंटिंग द स्कीम. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, डेजिग्नेशन ऑफ अ स्टेट नोडल एजेंसी. सबसे पहले क्या होता है, स्टेट नोडल एजेंसी का को डेजिग्नेट किया जाता है. देन कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ अ स्टेट लेवल एम्पावर्ड कमिटी. ओके, देन आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ अ स्टेट टेक्निकल सपोर्ट एजेंसीज. एंड ऑफकोर्स गाइज दीज स्टेप्स यू डोंट हैव टू रिमेम्बर. देन सिलेक्शन ऑफ क्लस्टर्स, देन अप्रूवल ऑफ द रर्बन क्लस्टर्स, देन सेटिंग अप ऑफ डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल कमिटी, देन प्रिपरेशन ऑफ ICAPS बाय द कंसर्न्ड स्टेट और द रिस्पेक्टिव स्टेट, देन सेटिंग अप ऑफ स्टेट प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट यूनिट, देन वी हैव सेटिंग अप ऑफ डिस्ट्रिक्ट प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट यूनिट एंड क्लस्टर प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट यूनिट, अप्रूवल ऑफ ICAP बाय SLEC स्टेट लेवल एम्पावर्ड कमिटी, देन सबमिशन ऑफ ICAP एंड CGF क्रिटिकल गैप फंडिंग एप्लीकेशन टू द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रूरल डेवलपमेंट. उसके बाद क्या होता है, प्रिपरेशन ऑफ डिटेल्ड प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट्स. ओके, देन सबमिशन ऑफ अप्रूव्ड DPRs. व्हाट इज दिस DPRs? दिस इज बेसिकली डिटेल्ड प्रोजेक्ट रिपोर्ट एंड क्रिटिकल गैप फंडिंग एप्लीकेशन टू द स्टेट लेवल एम्पावर्ड कमिटी. देन सबमिशन ऑफ अप्रूव्ड CGF एप्लीकेशन टू द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ रूरल डेवलपमेंट, टू द सेंट्रल मिनिस्ट्री, एंड फाइनली इसके बाद प्रोजेक्ट वर्क क्या होता है, स्टार्ट हो जाता है. ओके, सो दीज आर द स्टेप्स दैट आर फॉलोड इन द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द स्कीम. एंड दिस इज जस्ट फॉर द बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द स्कीम गाइस, कि इसमें हो क्या रहा है एक्चुअली. ओके, सो ये सारी चीजें हो रही हैं. एंड दैट्स इट फॉर द स्कीम. एंड गाइस, नाउ लेट्स डू इट वंस अगेन, लेट्स रिवाइज द स्कीम. सो रर्बन क्लस्टर, व्हाट इज अ रर्बन क्लस्टर? इट इज बेसिकली अ डेवलप्ड क्लस्टर ऑफ रूरल सेटलमेंट्स. एंड रिमेंबर वन थिंग हियर, दैट इन द प्लेन एंड इन द कोस्टल एरियाज अ रर्बन क्लस्टर इज दैट विच हैज अ पॉपुलेशन ऑफ 25,000 to 50,000. 25,000 से 50,000 की जिनकी पॉपुलेशन होती है इन द प्लेन एंड कोस्टल एरियाज, उसको हम बोलते हैं अर्बन क्लस्टर. वाइल इन द डेजर्ट हिली और द ट्राइबल एरियाज, दिस पॉपुलेशन क्राइटेरिया इज हाउ मच, 5,000 to 15,000. ओके, सो अर्बन क्लस्टर बेसिकली इट इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ विलेज दैट आर बीइंग डेवलप्ड अंडर दिस स्कीम विच इज नोन एज श्यामा प्रसाद मुखर्जी अर्बन मिशन. इट वॉज लॉन्च्ड इन द ईयर 2016 एज आई टोल्ड यू अर्लियर ड्यूरिंग द बिगिनिंग ऑफ द सेशन. It is being implemented by the Ministry of Rural Development and these are the components through which the development is being carried out in these urban clusters, and these components are being implemented through the convergence of various centrally sponsored, central sector and state government schemes. All right, and there is integrated cluster action plans which are being prepared by the states, and these plans required approval from the central governments, and also the critical gap funding also requires approval from the सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. इंस्टीट्यूशनल फ्रेमवर्क में वी हैव एट नेशनल लेवल, वी हैव नेशनल मिशन डायरेक्टरेट विच इज हेडेड बाय द जॉइंट सेक्रेटरी. देन स्टेट लेवल एनी डिपार्टमेंट दैट इज बीइंग नॉमिनेटेड बाय द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट. एट द डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल वी हैव डिस्ट्रिक्ट प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट यूनिट, एंड एट द क्लस्टर लेवल वी हैव द क्लस्टर डेवलपमेंट एंड मैनेजमेंट यूनिट. राइट, टॉकिंग अबाउट द एम्पावर्ड कमिटी, सो एट द नेशनल लेवल वी हैव एम्पावर्ड कमिटी विच इज हेडेड बाय द सेक्रेटरी under the Ministry of Rural Development, which has the roles and responsibility to approve the ICAPs and critical gap funding that was submitted by the states. Then state level wali jo empowered committee hai, that is headed by the chief secretary of that particular state, and it has the responsibility to approve the ICAPs before submitting it to the empowered committee at the national level or the national mission directorate. Okay, And this is the project funding. So the project is being funded through the various central government schemes and central sector scheme, and the gap between the required funds and the funds allocated is filled by the critical gap funding that is being funded by the central government, with the condition that the critical gap funding, through the critical gap funding, the funding will be provided either 30% of the project cost or rupees 30 crore, whichever is less. Okay, in the plain and coastal areas, while for the desert and hilly areas, it's rupees 15 crore, either rupees 15 crore or 30% of the project cost, whichever is less. Okay, and there is one innovation budget also with an additional amount of 5% of critical gap funding. Okay, and now guys, let's move on to the questions that can be asked in your exam from the scheme. So you have to consider the following statements regarding critical gap funding of the Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Railway Mission, and you have to identify the correct statements. So I hope guys you can easily answer these questions now. So statement one is, critical gap funding is provided to fulfill the gaps between the availability of funds from schemes and funds required for development of clusters. This is absolutely correct. CGF is capped at 40% of the project cost or rupees 40 crore. नहीं, 40% का कहीं कोई condition नहीं था, which means यही पे हम पढ़ते ही इस statement को wrong करार कर देंगे. CGF is capped at 30% of the project cost or rupees 30 crore, whichever is less in desert, tribal and hilly areas. No, that is not 30 crore in the desert, tribal and hilly areas, that's 15 crore, which means we have only one statement which is correct here, and therefore let us say this option is only one. So option C guys, only one will be the correct answer. Okay, let me check it once again. 40% wala condition hai nahi, 30% of the project cost, while in the desert, tribal and hilly areas it's rupees 15 crore, which means we have only one statement which is correct. Therefore option C, only one, will be the correct answer. And question number 2, how much additional percentage of the VGF, that's not VGF, that's critical gap funding, guys apology for this, has been provided as the innovation budget for research and development in the urban mission. Okay, so that's 5%. Innovation budget kitna hai isme, 5% hai. And moving ahead, how many urban clusters are targeted to be developed under Shyama Prasad Mukherjee mission in 5 years? So it's how much? 300 urban clusters are targeted to be developed under this scheme. And recently in the year 2020, this scheme seeks an extension of 2 years. Ministry of Rural Development ne bola hai ki hame 2 saal aur chahiye hamare jitne bhi projects hain unko complete karne ke liye. But yes, these 2 years has not been sanctioned till now. Let us see wo sanction kab hota hai. Agar ho jayega to I will update you all. Alright. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all complete scheme is clear and all the questions are also clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ek naye session mein ek nayi scheme ke saath. Goodbye, take care and God bless.